Ladies and gentlemen, I will welcome you to my hypnotic world.
Listen, baby, ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough, baby.
If you need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far.
Don't worry, baby.
Just call my name, I'll be there in a hurry. You don't have to worry, cause
oh, baby,
have been fascinated by feats of engineering.
I know.
Southern California with my junior college team, and I met a gentleman who really impressed me. As some of you may know him, his name's Nick, and I watched both the speech he gave and of course talked with him before and after the round, and he seemed like a really nice guy. Of course, I didn't know that there was a whole group of people a lot like him, nice, good people that I would get to know in my life. I just wanted to extend a thank you to all those people as I got a chance to say goodbye. Not just Judy or Dr. Ray, but every single person on the team, in addition to the extensive number of people who really support this team, both in its financing and diplomacy. This past year we made a lot of goals. One of my goals was for us to try and win every single national, international, and state tournament we went to. And because of the hard work of those people who were important to this team, we managed to do so. So thanks for making my season one I'll never forget.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Barry Fields with the News Hour from the desk of Nicole Hall. I figured all of y'all have been here now at the banquet for probably about 2 hours, judging on past years, so I'm not going to keep this really too long, and if I did, I might torture you. Ben said that the minutes had to be pretty short, less than five, so that's a torture in and of itself. We're supposed to appreciate and talk about the people that have influenced us over these years, and I'd just like to thank you guys for all the influence that you've had on me, the relationships, the friendships, the memories that we've created. It's really been a good time. I think I said in the yearbook that I'm going to miss, more so than the traveling, the conversations that we've had over the last few years. Most specifically, Ben Pyle, I'm really going to miss talking about your mother. That is going to be something in days gone by, something that will be gone forever. I'm going to miss that a lot, buddy. To all of you that are on the team and will be on the team next year or maybe moving on, I just wanted to give my sincere appreciation for all that you've done. I love you and appreciate you. We'll do anything for you. You can call me anytime as long as it's not before 10 o'clock at night because I watch Andy Griffith go to bed at that hour. But anytime afterward, it's just fine. Thank you, Judy and coaches and administration for all the support that you've given over the last few years. It's been a great ride. And thank you for allowing us to go on top. I think it's true that we can say Johnny Dunn swept those Nats. So let's do it again next year.
So this is my part of the video where I get to tell you guys something. I guess what I would like to say first is to all the future seniors on the team, freshmen through juniors this year. You guys are great. And you guys are amazingly talented, and I'm so very proud of each and every one of you. You've accomplished so much while you've been here, and you've grown so much, and I can't wait to see what you're going to do whenever you guys are seniors. You guys have so many national titles in your hands, you have no idea. I would like to say for the future seniors that you're going to take on leadership roles. You need to act like a leader, not just for yourself, but for your teammates. And don't compromise who you are or what you believe in. for anything or anyone. Be yourselves and be proud of it. It's been a terrific ride for me to get to know each and every one of you, and I've made some of the best friends of my life here within this team. For the fellow seniors, you guys have taught me a lot, and I can't wait to see what you guys are going to accomplish within your lives. It's going to be amazing. You guys are such a talented, wonderful group of people, and I'm very proud of you. And for the coaches, thank you so much for those of you who believed in me to push me along like you have. And you've inspired me and motivated me, and I appreciate that. And thank you for this great opportunity, and it's been fun, and I love you guys.
Hi everybody, I just wanted to let you know that as a senior, I've really enjoyed my time, not only here at Western, but also in the speech community. But I did learn one really valuable lesson. It's really not about the plastic and fake wood trophies that we get every week. Instead, it's about the memories that you make on the way. So my message is this: make all those memories count. Have great years and friends, and I wish you the best.
Long 4 years, and not many of you have been with us for all 4 years, and some of you have only been able to know for just 2 short semesters. But I have to say thank you to everyone. This has been the most amazing experience, from watching everyone perform to just hanging out and doing warm-ups in the middle of a field and asphalt. Wherever we were at NFA, it was fantastic. So we've grown a lot. I think when Lydia and I were first here with Barry at the very first team meeting, there were 20 of us doing warm-ups together, and then this year we barely fit in a massive circle in the middle of the ballroom. So I think the one thing I just want to impart upon you after my years of wisdom is that no matter how big the team gets and how many debaters, night years that we have, and how many different tournaments we go to, that this is your family, and you have to love each and every person, not all the time, but you will love them in the long run. And just don't forget that each person can really give you a different perspective and add a lot of value to your life. So don't neglect anyone, and certainly if you're here for 2 semesters or for 4 years, that this is the most enjoyable experience many of us will ever have. So certainly enjoy it, and thank you for making it the best 4 years of my life.
Hey team, now some of you might be wondering why I'm walking down the stairs right now, and where am I? I'm in the basement of Cherry Hall, and I thought I'd take you to our humble beginnings. My freshman year, first semester, this was our speech office. I walked out of the speech office. It's symbolic, really. But basically, this was where I started my speech career. This is where I started to become a part of Western's family and make all the friends that I have made in the past 4 years. And I wasn't even supposed to be here, really. Judy followed me to the bathroom at NFL for my final round, and she gave me a business card. And I was super surprised and glad, and I think about it almost every day, how lucky I am to be here and to know all of you and to have had the experiences that I've had. And when I was a senior, see, there are classes going on, it's great. How many people were seeing all the time? When I was a senior, I had to say something to my senior class back in high school, and it was an anecdote that my high school coach gave me. It's been their opinion back then, and basically it was by John Milton, and it's from Paradise Lost, and it the leaves have to leave the Garden of Eden, and even though they're really sad because they have to leave Eden, John Milton wrote, "Some natural tears they dropped, but wiped them soon. The world was all before them." So to my fellow seniors, it's been great to be able to share this time with you. To all the underclassmen below me, you really haven't been below me. You've been my friends and my comrades through thick and thin. And I just want to say thank you, and see you around.